Infective hepatitis, that is hepatitis A, is the commonest cause of jaundice seen in general practice. The patient presents with fever and severe anorexia. Anorexia is usually so severe that patient does not feel like even looking at food. Very few conditions have such severe anorexia. He will also have severe weakness and pain in the right hypochondrium, in the liver region. After 1 or 2 days, a yellow tinge will appear in the sclera and liver will become palpable. It is very soft and tender. So, if you want to detect jaundice early, whenever the patient has anorexia and fever, first examine the sclera for yellow discoloration. The sclera must be examined in good sunlight. Take the patient near the window if necessary, because mild degrees of icterus will not be appreciated in artificial light, whether it is tube light or bulb. Secondly, ask whether the urine has become dark yellow or reddish. If not, but you are suspecting jaundice, ask the patient to watch the urine color for next 2 to 3 days and inform if it becomes dark. Now, if jaundice is detected, what else will you look for in the patient? Ask if there is itching. Itching will be seen in any deep jaundice, but severe itching is very typical of obstructive jaundice. This much history is enough in case of infective hepatitis. But if there is no fever, anorexia is not severe, there is only jaundice, then other types of jaundice should be considered. Ask for history of colicky pains in the right hypochondrium for gallstones causing obstructive jaundice. Ask whether he is taking any drugs which could be hepatotoxic, like anti-tuberculous drugs or antipsychotic drugs. Ask whether he is immunized against hepatitis B. If not, is there any history of exposure to STD or history of blood transfusion or serum injections? Then palpate for the liver. Liver in infective hepatitis is very, very soft, and you can feel it only if you palpate carefully. And it is always tender. So tenderness in the right hypochondrium is also very suggestive. Occasionally, you may come across the less common causes. For example, a hard, nodular, large liver may suggest malignancy, especially in elderly patients. Then, if gallbladder is palpable along with the jaundice, it suggests obstructive jaundice. Palpable spleen and ascites may suggest cirrhosis of liver with failing liver. So to summarize, look for yellow sclera in every patient as a routine, but particularly in patients with severe anorexia, weakness and fever, and also ask about dark colored urine. Then palpate the abdomen carefully for liver, gallbladder and spleen. Now we will come to the treatment of infective hepatitis. Complete bed rest is very essential, and you must stress on this point strongly till the jaundice starts decreasing and liver enzymes are returning to normal. The diet should be totally free from fats, butter, oil and ghee. The patient may have soft rice, idli, bread, toast, fulka, soups, fruits, all vegetables, but without oil. Avoid meat, eggs, peanut and oil seeds. Let the patient eat plenty of carbohydrates and sweets. I advise the patient to take 50 grams of Glucon-D powder every day. If the jaundice is deep, give IV 25% glucose 3 to 4 ampules every day. Alcohol must be strictly avoided. Regarding drinking water, everyone in the house should drink boiled water. Coming to drug treatment, supportive treatment to the liver is with phospholipids like tab essentiale 2 TDS and silymarin like tab silibon 140 mg BD. You may also add Ayurvedic liver support like tab Liv 52 or Livomin 2 TDS. Also, give a high dose of B complex, Capbicosuls 1 BD, and injection B-plex port intramuscularly every day. If vomiting and nausea are excessive and intake is poor, then give IV fluids with multivitamin, that is MVI ampule, and give 3 to 4 ampules of 25% glucose IV every day. If the patient has a lot of itching, give tab cetirizin 1 OD and calamine lotion to be applied locally to the skin. Now, which investigations will you ask for when jaundice is seen or suspected? Routinely ask for serum bilirubin, liver enzymes, SGOT, SGPT and serum alkaline phosphatase, Australia antigen, that is HBsAg, and urine for bile salts and bile pigments. If obstructive jaundice is suspected, ask for ultrasound of the liver and gallbladder. Now, when do you suspect obstructive jaundice? Obstructive jaundice is seen very uncommonly in general practice. If the jaundice is deep and has lemon yellow color, there is no fever, appetite is relatively good. If there is lot of itching, if there is history of colicky pains in the right hypochondrium, and if the stools are white in color, then obstructive jaundice is suspected. Also, if the jaundice does not start reducing with routine treatment, suspect obstructive jaundice. On examination, a palpable gallbladder suggests obstructive jaundice. And on investigation, serum bilirubin is raised and it is mainly direct bilirubin. Liver enzymes are markedly raised. Then again, it is a obstructive jaundice. The definitive diagnosis will be made on ultrasound or CT scan of the abdomen. So ask for ultrasonography, which shows the obstruction, whether it is a stone in the CBD or a growth. It will show the dilated CBD and dilated intrahepatic bile ducts. The patient should then be referred to a gastroenterologist or a surgeon for further management. Now, if the jaundice is very deep, then what precautions should one take? As a general practitioner, if the jaundice is very deep, do not treat in your clinic. Send the patient immediately to a well-equipped hospital where services of gastroenterologist and medical ICU are available. Because these are very high-risk patients and may